All right, hi guys. We're here on the WeWork West Coast Tour here in 2019. And for those unfamiliar with WeWork, they've been making headlines with the current IPO valuations and the rise of shared workspaces. Plain and simple, they charge $350 a month for individuals to access these shared workspaces with all the startup amenities you can think of. Need a desk or conference room with high-speed Wi-Fi and don't want to get begging for Starbucks? Well, WeWork is for you. No more hushed huddling at a library or coffee shop with prospective business partners. Wi-Fi, clean workspaces, soundproof booths, outlets, printers, a coffee machine, espresso machine, and kegs of locally sourced beer, or my favorite, sparkly water on tap. Think 24-hour fitness. A WeWork can be anywhere, in any city or metropolis that you can access to plug in your phone or laptop with a speedy connection to get to work. So here's the review of WeWork. And full disclosure, I'm not paid by WeWork at all. This is an honest review of my own purchase of having a WeWork Global Access membership. Here's an invoice of my payment. Now, on the West Coast, yes, we drove from Seattle to San Francisco, Palo Alto, San Jose, and Los Angeles to take a look at all the office spaces. You be the judge if it's worth it. Now, of the office visits, Seattle was great for its outdoor patio, beautiful green in the concrete jungle. San Francisco was prideful for being the first WeWork ever. Palo Alto for having a shuffleboard and easy access parking. San Jose is my personal winner for freaking basketball. Basketball hoops, how can you get tired of that? And lastly, LA, just for being open past 6 p.m. when I arrived there on my road trip, minutes late, able to access the office. Now, if we take away my elation for shooting hoops at the office in San Jose, my favorite WeWork space would be the one with the least people, the most room, outdoorsy, the Seattle space. But they all offer you strong Wi-Fi, and their rise with their exponential and volatile IPO may open more bare offices, and this all can change with this volatility of their IPO landscape. So get a tour while you can. For small businesses, I think it's worth it. Overall, my take is that for traveling professionals or startup junkies, WeWorks are a huge relief to know you will always have a place to call your work home. However, parking for me in these new cities was always an issue. A coin toss to see if you can find a place, and if I had a preference for a home offerance, or have to drag myself out to the downtown city districts, like hustling and bustling, honestly, I'd rather stay home out of convenience. But for cleanliness, amenities, and exclusive space, additional use cases like biz meetings, hell yes, it's worth it to me. You just feel productive, like you belong in whatever city you're visiting or working at when you need to double down. Coffee, espresso, WeWork events by their employees and the staff, sparkly water, fruit water, conference rooms, soundproof booths, it feels like a professional home. There's something about a premium public workspace, almost like I'm at university again, recapturing college camaraderie. With some drawbacks being spottiness of the WeWork app, a coin toss for the parking situation for each of the offices per city that you visit, and the general eeriness of some of the WeWork offices being outright empty. Granted, many of these office spaces only opened weeks or months ago at the time of this review in September 2019. This concept of a Starbucks workplace without the Starbucks or any of the glaring employees or the expectation to buy anything, no more businesses trying to kick you out if you're a tourist working and traveling like a nomadic professional wherever you are, I think it's worth it. So, here are tours of the offices on the West Coast for your viewing pleasure. Yes, I drove hours upon hours, 14 plus, to get this footage. Comment below what your favorite office is from this footage and prepare for the rise of shared office workspaces following this 24-hour fitness model. So I'll have a gym membership in all cities, office spaces in all cities, Who knows next? Maybe I'll have a place to sleep in all these cities. Let me know what you think about WeWork, its IPO, its valuations, all in the comments below. Otherwise, come join me for the tour, and we'll look forward to seeing you in the next review. Thanks, guys.
Woo! Yeah.